Hello guys, it's Funkafile and today I will make a guide, a random hero guide again. And as you can see, I just randomed a Gyro. And I can say that Gyro is out of meta, but sometimes LGD is picking and making it work, and it's always good with an IO player with you guys, just bear in mind. Yes, I can play. And one thing guys, before I start giving information and etc, I have a trouble with my computer at the moment. My computer is not working, so I kinda borrowed my friend's computer at the moment and I'm playing with his computer. And this is kinda why I wasn't able to post any YouTube guides or make any Twitch streams. So basically my computer is not working and either motherboard or the processor is not working, so we will see it later on. And that's the reason that I was not posting in a while, and this is my first game after three or four days. And let's see how this one goes. I think it's gonna be a fine game because I'm already on my Smurf account. So and before we start video guys, if you are watching with adblock, please turn off your adblocks. If you're watching it on your computer or desktop, just please turn off your adblocks and watch the video like that so I can earn some money and I can just keep doing this thing guys. Alright, let's get into the video guys. As I mentioned earlier, Gyro is not the most famous hero, but I believe this hero will get some buffs like very soon, cause it has been out of meta for a long while and it's just getting only picked by IO, and that's only in pubs, cause in pubs you are not really like facing with strong enemies. So
your turn to pick.
That's why it's kind of strong. It's not really strong in like some captain's mode, but I believe this hero will get a lot stronger. It will get some buffs, like not a lot, but some buffs that will make this hero viable again. So I think it's a good random, to be honest. And I already have my IO, and you can always ask someone to pick IO for you guys, because it's really important. Like if you have an IO, it's just hero's power strike. Like hero is just a lot stronger than it normally is. But LGD is even playing without IO. If you're playing without IO guys, you can always consider buying Aghanim's, because Aghanim's is really good in this hero. It gives you mana, it gives you the HP pool, it gives you like basically plus one attack, almost like two times a second I believe. And it gives you stud as I mentioned, so it's a pretty good item. But in this game I will not go for Aghanim's, and I didn't buy a lot of regen, because I'm already playing with IO, and I will not need... Oh, wait. I have to set the settings guys, because I'm first time playing with this computer and oh my god, the settings are too high. Oh my god, Dota is beautiful guys. Dota is beautiful. Oh, Mustafa! Kardeş, ayarlar yüksekte oynuyorum ben şu an. Gözlerim bozuldu amına koyayım. Ayarlar güzel diye gözlerim bozuldu. Dur, videodayım ona göre. Ama geri çıkabilirsin, sorun yok. Hayır oğlum. Yok, şu an yüksekte ayarlar. Hani sen bir düşüyor. Ona rağmen... Hocam benimki şuradaydı amına koyayım, bak göstereyim. Ben böyle oynuyordum bilgisayarı. Yani, o da şu an yüksek hali bile. Böyle bile oynamıyordum. Hocam öyle aynen. Vallahi benim bilgisayar bilmiyorum, çöpe attı ya herhalde. Alright guys, let's get back into the video. FPS 140. It's pretty good, what the fuck? This computer is really stronger than mine. But it really doesn't have much, like you know, it's just a bit better. It should have been just a little bit better, but it feels like it's a lot more better than my computer. Oh my god guys, I feel awkward now. Hocam işlemcisi benzer ya, hepsi benzer. Hocam benzer. Şimdi hadi git, ben birazdan konuşuruz. Hadi videoya geçeyim, anladın mı? Evet oğlum. Alright boys, so I'll just run at this guy, because I can just do this. Where's my IO? You can always trade guys, as you can see. I'm pretty fine with trading, because as I mentioned earlier, we have IO, which means that I will have the sustain to stay on this lane. And I can even zone them out, as you can see. Right boys, you can see this side of camp, and like really guys, it feels so weird right now. Like even the settings are a bit lower now, and it still feels weird, so I'm still in effect of that. And alright, let's get back into the video, guys. We will talk about this thing later on, maybe when I'm streaming. And this computer will be with me, guys, for a couple days, so it's not gonna last longer. It's not gonna last like long time. So, all right. So basically, like, pretty strong in this matchup, guys, because as I mentioned, like, all the time, we have sustain, like, we have infinite sustain because of IO, and I can always trade with them. And what we should do, we should just try to deny creeps, try to like harass them whenever they get close, of course. And just don't let them farm anything. I will just go rush for my boots, because boots are really important in, like, with the zero. If you get one like real quick, you can just run at people and kill people. We can try to pull the next wave or stack, yeah. And of course it's a bit hard to CS, but once you get used to it, you will be a lot better CS with CSing. And right now I'm not sure who is right, like, post 4. Feels like Windranger is post 4 and Winter is taking the creeps, the CS, for some reason, I don't know. And you can always pull the wave, guys, as you can see. I will just use my third spell just to zone them out so they can't stop me from pulling. And as you can see, just when you're playing carry, guys, like, your support should always go for some pulls. Doing that, you're getting solo XP on the lane, which means, like, I'm right now level 3, guys, right? Because they're level 2 and I'm level 3. So if something happens, we're gonna be pretty strong. That's a pretty good plus for us. Like, if you get your level 3 earlier than enemy does, you can just get some kills. And as you can see, I'm just CSing, guys, not doing anything much.
He's dead, just back.
And you can always abuse this pool. Don't forget about this, you just need to eat the right trees. I'll just put it down and get my boots. You can try to pull again, it's free lane for me. Yeah, just go. Oh, feels weird, boys. I haven't played Dota for like a long while. And as you can see, we are doing the pull things. We're just denying some creeps and getting our farm. Like, our farm is really important with Gyro, because once we get our level 6, like, you don't have to always get kills. But, like, in this lane, we are playing against two ranged heroes, so it's pretty hard to get kills on them, unless they make a mistake. But, like, when you're playing IO Gyro, you should always, like mostly you're having two, like, one of them are just being melee hero, and the melee heroes, you can just harass them. I'll run at this guy. Just harass him. I have missed some CS, but it's worth, guys. Oops. Oh. Losing on purpose. Oh, it's fine. He got his bottle.
Come on, get a bit bottom, go. Oh, what?
We can pull again. Or we can go for runes, actually. Now you get your bottle. Go. Let's him wait. What's that? Can tether me. Get your bottle and bottle me up, Ion. Come.
Get the other
one. Bottle me, Ion, first. Buy a bottle from here. Oh, okay. Alright, it's fine. He just bought it from the base, I didn't expect that. Just spent, like, wasted a bit of time, but it's fine. Not the end of world. Once I get my level 5, we can go on them. As you can see, guys, like, our level is pretty high just because we pulled some, and we can just go on. But I think this guy is dead. Next lane is fated far. This guy made a huge mistake. Yep. That guy is fated, but I hope he will not win the game, so this guide can be useful for you since I didn't post any game for a long while and I don't really have much time. I hope he will not win the game. Yeah, we can farm it later when I level 6, when I get my level 6. And as you can see guys, I'm not much to tell you at the moment. I'm just buying like face boots, some drums, just gives me stud, and like these items will make me run at people, and I will be able to I will have enough stats and I will have enough MS to run at people and kill them all, and etc, and kill them. So it's pretty good. It's always good to go for such items. And I will raise courier, and when you're using courier bot guys, you should always just wait for courier. I will get some items too. Like when you're using courier to some side lanes boys, always always try to use them at the same time, like just now I did. If you use the courier bot before I did, and the courier will go back, and I will, if I use it again to get my items, it will take like forever. And I'm sure like someone will get tilted, someone will not get his item in time, so always watch out for that. And other than that, I can just, you can farm jungle with your second spell. It's free lane already. Like you can also do this guys, when you win your own lane, you can just send that IO, farm the jungle, and you can just solo XP, get the solo XP on the lane. Right? Solo XP is really important. My team is good, again. Can you kill them? Can you come? Can you come? Can you come? Can you come?
Let me the courier please.
No, okay.
We use. Wanna kill the Viper again?
That was a pretty bad play by me.
Viper bottom, I'm coming.
Run.
Just wait for me.
Alright. I can turn. I might die here, but it's fine guys. This enemy is mid laner and they will die also in return, like most likely one of them. So it's a pretty fine trade for us. We can take this trade, but I kinda failed there with that ulti. And one thing guys I want to mention, I might have bought like one more like plus one raid band instead of like you can just buy one raid band, one drum, and just get magic wand and some items like raindrops and etc, and you can just go farm your next item. Just bear in mind. Like you don't have to go for two raid bands, since you're going to buy drums, you will have enough stats already anyway. Just bear in mind guys. And like for now, we will just farm this like camps, the lane, and if he gets close, we will just run at them. That's our play so far. We can just basically do this boys like forever, and no one can lane against us at the moment because we're pretty strong. Like whenever someone gets close, he will just run at them and we will just kill them. And as you can see guys, he's almost level 6, and when you're playing Io Gyra, when you're playing Io Luna, it's always similar. You're just getting your level 6 very early, around like even minute 9 if you get some kills, and with that you can just gank some side lanes guys. It's really useful. And when it comes to item build guys, it's kind of optional. You can always go greedy and get some milestone first to just to be able to out farm the enemy and etc, but it's always optional boys, just keep in mind what to go for. You can, if the game is going good for you, and if the enemy, like if you have if you need some magical damage, like milestone is always good, especially when you have IO guys. So I think you can always go for that item, but unless you're going like unless you're having a great game, you can consider buying some other items as well, like as first item. I mean, like instead of just buying, for example, Milestorm first item, you can just go for Yasha, just a Yasha and drums, and then you can get Milestorm, then maybe even BKB. But if the game is going well for you, you can just go get greedy and buy Milestorm. You can relocate base and Yep. Nice. I'll just get a raindrop charge, just a raindrop, and then we are fine. Now we are super strong. It's a pleasure, we are super strong now.
Chase.
I want that CS. Nice. Let's go, don't pull. Oh, you wanna farm?
This monk is level 4, don't even wanna go. If you leave him alone, he's done.
And after that item I will go for Yasha. And most likely to make it a drum. Sending Yasha boys. And like after maxing your first spell, you can always go like max your third spell, because it will give you it will make you a lot stronger in team fights, guys. And like always use your, you can always use your rocket just to zone him even out. You can tether me. You should tether me. It is better at rezoning. I want this tower. I misclick again this magic wand, like for third time. Don't misclick your magic wands, boys. They are really important. You should not waste your magic wand charts by misclicking them. Just like I did. Right, it's fine. And as you can see, guys, game is pretty simple. You are not even doing much when you have IO, and maybe later, guys, like this video, guys, will be a lot more often. So, like for example, I just did this round of gyro guide, right? And for example, I'm playing with IO. You can maybe ask for me like to play without IO, and like if you're if you want to see that, you can always do that, and we make that video as well. In mind, boys, like I am going to help you as much as I can, and you can always ask for things just like this that can be useful, that you can you think that it's gonna be useful for you. I gotta watch out a bit. I'll just tip out. If he just did the same thing, he will tip out. Maybe it still does. Alright, it's fine. Like I had to TP out because there was that there. If I stayed a bit longer, then we could die just there together. So it's much better that he just died, and we are still fine. I can pressure steal some side lanes, some even like I will play mid, and then I will run top, guys, because they just TP'd like three heroes on bot, and I believe that they will be playing there for a while. Actually, we already got this tower, so I did not notice that. And now I just did. I will just pressure mid a bit, then play top their top jungle, boys. Because this is like a kind of safer place, because if I play here, they can like just get initiate on us as 5. But if they play top, boys, right now, they can't be like on 3 lanes, right? If I play mid, if we play close to mid lane, unless you are 5 maining, of course. If you are 5 maining, you can just stay like mid and of course push the tower. But right now we are not 5 maining, we are just out farming enemy. So, and we are already killing them. And if they just get split up, we will just, we're just gonna kill them all. So our goal is just to pressure lanes and make them split. Because if they get 5 heroes on like one lane, they can still win a fight. Even though they are like pretty behind, they can still win. I will run it.
What you're mumbling?
And as you can see, boys, they just like like had a fight on like 5 heroes on mid, right? So I just pressured top and I just TP'd out when they were running top, and now I'm pressuring bot. Like, they're desperately trying to catch me, because as you can see, I'm like farming really fast, and I'm just out farming all of them, and once I get my BKB, I will be kind of immortal, and I might not even go for BKB. You know, I can just go for Satanic and some items, and I will be immortal even. As long as we are like speeded up against Winter, it's fine, and Io is a... Winter is a pretty good counter of Io, so just bear in mind. We can read the top, but we need plus one top already. Tether me, Io. Always. So we run faster, tether me. Tether me so we run faster, yeah. Let us farm mid, don't farm mid. We can go rush. Push top so we can connect top together and we kill top. They might have ward here.
They definitely do.
Can fight. Can you relocate and save me here? That stuff feels bad, but it's fine. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. The problem that my IO is not like... He should always tether me, no matter like, even if he's going to save Batrider, if even this Batrider has 20 kills, he should always tether me, so I can fight them. And he got ultied here, solo, and he didn't tether me after, because I waited for him, like here. If he tethered me, I could've like killed all of them, maybe there even. With like, you know, just like running around when I have enough damage, you know, and just dodging some things and just going back in and etc. Since I have a lot of MS, like I could just do that, I could just outmaneuver enemy. But he just didn't tether me. So it was kind of bad of him. But still fine. Not the worst fight, I got some kills. And they both back online.
Go top with Wiz from your terror.
Can we go on 5 people, dudes?
We don't need the 5 men, just 3 men and we will relocate. Simple. You must always tether me, no matter what I owe. I will get BKB now, not just to not hit you. Yes, I should come to me still. Where is he? The fuck? He lassoed him and he ran away. Not expecting that. Like, he took away, took him away from me. That's what I was not expecting. And at minute, like, at Toland 15, guys, I go for left. It gives me higher damage on Rocket Barrage, and I don't think that the right side is really good, because it got changed, guys, as you all know. It used to be a lot better, but now. Is what we
They're
can get.
All there, all there.
And when you're playing with Io, like against any, like with anyone, like Luna doesn't matter, like with any hero, always be tethered, guys. So your tether won't be on cooldown. if you like just get unconnected, like just vid it, it's not on cooldown. Always tether me when you have, so it won't be cooldown. Yeah, always stay like that. Push top. Go. As you can see, guys, I'm like farming super fast, like, because your hero is already super fast, and you have just you're just having IO next to you, and your hero just has some talents. IO should get, yeah, like some has some spells that can make you farm a lot faster. So if you're playing Gyro, if you're ahead, of course you can always pressure, guys. You can always pressure because you're ahead, right? Because Gyro is a early carry, like this Gyro, like is good at early, good at mid game, good at late game, if you have especially IO with you. So, in this game, as you can see, like I'm not only farming, I'm also pressuring sideways and getting map control. Like pressuring, it doesn't always mean that you're just getting some kills, you just run at enemies and get some kills. If my team plays correct, there will be some kill opportunities, of course, because they're not going to be 5. Because I'm pushing every lane, I'm pressuring lanes, and since I pushed bot, they will not like, this guy is showing bot, right? Bot lane is pushed. I did not push, but someone pushed. So he's showing here. So we are pretty, like we are feeling pretty free right here, guys. We can just get a pick off, just like we did on Viper. And we take another tower. And after, for example, they come defend here, we will push some other lanes. And maybe we'll get rush. So this is kind of the right play, just bear in mind. And I think I will go for Satanic boys. Because, like, my goal is just to be immortal and I will have enough damage already. You can relocate bot if... Never mind. He's dead. He'll die. Maybe he dies too. Yeah. It's fine. It's good. That's why he picked that hero. Not much special boys, as you can see. Of course my team did well, but if they even didn't do this well, I will still most likely do the same. I will just focus on my own farm and pressure the side lanes when it's needed. And of course, like, if enemy is just running at me at top lane, I will just run bot. I'll try to... Oops, okay, I cannot escape from that. But it's fine. We got the... Oh, we didn't have the rocks, but not the worst thing, guys. And you can always refresh your drum charts, because I think drum is pretty good on this hero, like even just to press it and just having a lot more MS and etc. That's fine. We can just go rush now. I'm almost having my stunning and it's fine. Of course, like this IO nerfs kinda made like IO Gyro, IO Luna duos weaker, but as you can see they are still strong. It's just you're just becoming super strong a bit later than you like you used to do. You were like used to getting level 15 Aghanim's talent and you were just being super strong at minute 15, not at level 15, but now you're just getting your item, like getting your levels a bit just a bit later, so it is still strong. We don't care much. As you can see, guys, Rocket Polish Talent is also good. Like, I am dealing a lot of magical damage. Yeah, I will go rush with my Satanic, guys. Wait for it. I'm almost having it. Play with me all the time. Play S3, IO play with me, so we can relocate if someone catches somebody. Not farm jungle, play with me. I don't think that they can try to kill me, because they think that IO is behind me. Rinse. Don't go like over. Go back, go back, go back. It's fine. Guys, just please stop, like, just play around me, Io, okay? You and me, we can even win this game solo. Just play with me. Don't tether anybody else, okay? Even though if you can save them, just don't do it and play with me all the time. I don't care if someone dies, okay? I don't care. Just tether me and we are immortal. Alright, I almost got my satanic voice. All we should do, just my Io to tether me and the game is over. Of course, I just get my satanic, we go rush, we get Aegis, we go high ground, we kill somebody, and the game is over. But we're kinda postponing, we're kinda delaying the game, because, you know, like, Sky is, what is Sky hitting Shrine, and etc. So, but the problem, as I mentioned, that Io is tethering them, not me. But it's fine. Buy dust. By dust, they have Glimmer. Run top, I will just farm it. Go rush now. Now rush is free, we can just get the rush and then the game is over. I should just fan line. My team just should sit behind me. You can fight them if they come. I'm going for fire. I think it's like kinda get it's better to buy BKB in this game, but we will see, boys. If this game just lasts a bit longer, I think I will go for BKB just to not to hit Io. Io doesn't die. We are immortal, like we can't die. So I might consider buying BKB later on, but if things goes well for us, I will just go get fly. With fly I will have a lot more damage. It's gonna boost my damage output, it's gonna boost my survivability and everything.
I have no vision.
Here. Right now I have pretty like high magic service resistance, which is really important. As you can see. Dust. I will kill them all.
No winter, no winter.
Yep.
Winter bye-bye.
Any procs? Any procs?
Bye-bye to Vision, really?
Yeah,
go ahead. Come to me. Wow.
You're just gonna die.
Force up here, just run.
I can't die, it's fine. Nice, And the game is over, guys. They bought back with almost like so many heroes, and they, I don't know, like Viper survived with 10 HP in the first fight, and then they just came back in, they killed Io and etc. But as you can see, guys, fight is ours because I have a lot of status resistance, I have a lot of MS, and I have a lot of farm. Most important, I have a lot of farm levels. And this Io is not even level 20 as I mentioned, boys. And imagine that Io just being level 20 at this fight. Tom the book, Io. Just let me hit and stay behind me. I have this if they come close. I want to kill that guy. The game is over, boys. In this fight, not much to tell, just go for the target that doesn't really have escape and like try to burst them down. Or like, for example, Winter and Lion, the most important two targets, to be honest, for me. And if I get locked down, they can kill me. If I get if I get Winter cursed, they can kill me. So my goal is just to go on these guys first, then the rest, of course. And as you can see, I got the Aghanims now. I would have that Aghanims at minute 32, and if this game wasn't really going well for us, we would win this game at minute 40, let's say, with my with Io's 20. So I don't know what to say, guys. I think we almost all have some basic knowledge about Io and Gyro, duo especially. And as I mentioned, if you need a Gyro, solo Gyro, just Gyro guide, just let me know, guys, and I will try to make that guide. And let's swap some comments. And as I will just show you guys the graphics. You can just see how ahead we were. Like, this was against 2 range hero, and imagine if you're playing against some Eggs, some Nightstalker, I don't know, Centaur, you will have a lot of more kill potential. So even your laning stage could gone a lot better. Right, boys, that was it for me. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys liked the video. If you guys liked the video, leave a thumbs up, comment on it, and let me know about your thoughts. Guys, I'm always reading all comments, but I'm not always replying all of them, but I'm reading all of them. So that's it for me, guys. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.